With so much heritage, there is a danger that Bath becomes a living museum rather than a thriving modern city. How does it respond to the challenge? Well, to find out, I've come for a morning dip in Bath's spring waters with Martin Palmer, local resident and expert on Bath's history and culture.
I don't know about you, but it's not very often I get to swim in an open-air pool.
No, and I think I can see why.
It's rather bracing.
It's bracing.
What I love is that the Thermae Spa here, it does blend beautifully with the background, even though it is incredibly modern. You couldn't get more modern than this.
No, you couldn't, but what a spectacular view, too. I mean, you really do get a sense of the abbey here, just in front of the abbey, the actual Roman baths themselves, and then the medieval abbey itself, and around us the hills, which make this extraordinary sort of basin within which the hot waters rise and provide really just one of the most beautiful settings of a city anywhere you can imagine.
Is it a city steeped in history but struggling with the future?
It's a city that's got to wrestle with how on earth do you preserve Roman, Anglo-Saxon, medieval and of course Georgian cities with the needs of a modern city, because you can't just fossilize it, which is what some people would like to do. It's a city that is always having to say, we want to preserve this, but it's got to have a use. And this place is a fantastic fusion of exactly that.
Right, I'll race you to the other side. Come on.
The ability to fuse the old with the new is a challenge confronting much of the city. As Bath's only remaining Georgian parish church, St. Swithins is steeped in history. Two of its members, Alastair and Des, gave me a tour.
So the church is open to all, and
there's been a place of worship on this site since Saxon times. William Wilberforce was married here, so too were Jane Austen's parents, and her father is buried on the church grounds.
The slab is here, but his remains are under the crypt floor.
Ah, right, okay. But until recently, this church was in danger of becoming a relic. In desperate need of repair, most of the building was unusable.
It was a very dark and dismal place. Not somewhere where you would really feel welcome, and my children refused to come into this place. It was so horrible.
To save their church, the congregation raised money to renovate it. They successfully challenged English Heritage's restrictions on listed buildings. And in doing so, have brought their church back to life.
So it's completely different.
It's 150% transformed. You would not believe the difference.
So we've got, what, a cafe area and today a mother and toddlers group, is that right?
Yes. We have concerts, we have book signings, we have choirs coming to use the space for rehearsal. And it's just wonderful to see this place, which was dead, is full of life. It's full of life pretty much 7 days a week. And that is just fantastic.
So is this the proof that Bath is a mixture of old and new?
Yes, I think so. I think it's proof that there is life yet in the city. From the church's perspective, we're probably very well known, or probably most well known, for our connection with both William Wilberforce and also Jane Austen. But we like to think that our history didn't finish there. It's still alive today.